page number 149 in the notes. So, a summer camp has a milk dispenser that holds 1,536 fluid ounces. How many cups of milk are in the dispenser? So, we want to highlight what we're trying to find. So, how many, this is the question that we want to address. How many cups of milk are in the dispenser? So, the given information that we have to answer that question, I'm just going to write it over here. We know what we're trying to find. What given information do we have to find the answer? So, we have the milk dispenser holds 1,536 fluid ounces. So I'm going to write 1,536 fluid ounces. So that's important. That's how much the milk dispenser holds. And that's really what we want to convert into cups, because the question says how many cups. So we have to convert from ounces to cups in order to get the answer to the question. So we need to know the conversion factor, and you can go back to your conversion factor sheet, your reference sheet right here. And the conversion factor that we need to do is the conversion factor between cups and ounces, which is right here. So we need to use that conversion factor something on the right here. So one cup is equivalent to 8 ounces.
So Bluetooth is disconnected. So we want to convert
1,536 ounces into, so we want that to yield into cups. How many cups? We don't know, but we're going to use the equivalent standard conversion to figure that answer out. So we want to start with 1,536 ounces, and our goal is to get ounces to cancel out. So we're going to start with this.
So any number divided by itself equals 1. So since I have ounces in the numerator here, I need ounces to go to the bracket. So I'm going to go to my conversion factor, and I need to put 8 ounces in the denominator. And then equivalent to that is 1 cup. So I need to put 1 cup in the numerator. So I'm going to have ounces. The ounces here in the numerator cancels this ounces here. Divided by ounces is equivalent to what? So now we're left with just our final answer in cups, which will give us the answer to the question once we multiply and divide as necessary. So we can say this is equivalent to 1,536 times 1 cup. Now you can cross it with a comma, which is, you say you multiply across. Thank you. Thank you. The units must be located in the area.
A very recipe called the Robert So now that you know the conversion factors that we need to use, you can look at it and figure it out. So we want to start it. It's going to convert 100 grand. We're going to start with 500 grand. We're going to start with 500 grand. We're going to multiply that. And conversion factors, how to convert, how to transfer one kind of thing into another. So you use constant rate to do that. So constant rate, you know, we're not using the one that we're using here. Because we have grams in a numerator, we need grams in a denominator. So the number that's associated with grams is 10.14. And then, according to that, the conversion factor. So grams is going to cancel out the grams, and we're going to cancel out the ounces, but the final place is the pounds. So we need to actually use the other conversion factor. We need to set up, divide that, and then I'm going to get all that together. So now we need to let ounces to cancel out, because we have ounces in the numerator. I'm going to put ounces in the denominator. The number is associated with the ounces. And then when the ounces is contained, the pounds is equivalent to 4 grams. So now I have grams canceling out grams because any number divided by itself is 1. I have 1.5 grams. Ounces is going to cancel out with ounces. And I'm going to multiply it by the answer. Now I can multiply itself and divide. So for the numerator, I have 500 times 1 times 1, which is 130. And then for the denominator, I have 1 times 3 times 16, which is 464. So we have the aquarium right here. And we have some really useful
convert, you always want to know what you're converting. So we need to convert this 150 liters into, or yield to, hectoliters. That's the only way we can compare it to capacity is if the units of measurements are the same. Then we have to subtract, so this is by saying, then subtract what he poured in from the capacity. Which is right here. So we want to go over here to our conversion, our standard measurement, our capacity conversion, and we want to find hectoliters. So the conversion factor that we need is here. The constant equivalent rate is here. So the constant equivalent ratio is equal sign, equivalent ratio, equivalent rate. So we're going to start with our rate. So our rate is 1 hectoliter. For every 100 liters. And we want to set that equivalent to what we have. So we have 150 liters here. So I'm going to put liters equivalent to liters. So I need liters in the denominator. So I'm going to figure out how do I start with. Or you could be, a larger times what number will give me 150? Because that's the number that I need to multiply the 1 hectoliter by to get to the number of hectoliters. Then, that's equivalent to 150 liters. So I can use the basis to figure that out. So 150 divided by 100 will tell me that answer is 6.5 tenths. So if we multiply 1.5 tenths by 150, it'll take us to, or if we multiply 100 by 1.5 tenths, that is equivalent to 150. So since we have to multiply the denominator by 1.5 tenths, we can multiply the numerator by 1.5 tenths, and that's going to give us a touch down of 1.5 tenths. So 1.5 tenths is equivalent. So we can say that 150 liters is equivalent to 1.5 tenths. And then we can use that information to subtract the final answer. So if you want to use this for your purpose, I've got another option. When you subtract the answer, we can use the information.
So we want to start with 150 liters. And we want to convert it to hectoliters. Because we just did that on the other side. So we want to start with 150 liters.
Two tenths hectoliters, which is capacity.
to reach the gasoline. Because one of the 50 liters is equal to one of 5 liters. So
successfully cancel out my bills because I have one.
Thank you.